Jake Strong. How nice of you to join me.
What do you want from me, Valencio Day? Gabathio?
Why are you so suspicious? Can't I invite my friend over for a nice little chat? Sherry?
The last time I touched your sherry, I ended up in a mental hospital for 3 months! Then you convinced my half-brother to steal my father's fortune! So, I think I'll decline the sherry, even though it looks pretty good. I'm quite thirsty from riding my motorcycle over here.
As you wish, Jake Strong, as you wish.
I'll ask you again, what do you want?
Have a seat.
The last time I sat in one of your chairs, I was poisoned by an Amazonian tree frog. And I woke up hallucinating in a Nigerian diamond mine. Still have to go stand, thank you very much. Although I appreciate the sentiment.
Very well. Although standing can get uncomfortable.
So can my fist to your face!
Please, must you make these threats? I'm an old man, Jake Strong, and may not last long. In fact, there is a very real possibility that I'm dying of something very secretive. I don't know yet, and we might not find out for some time, but it's a definite possibility. So I'm going to make amends. You remember your wife, Nina?
You monster! What have you done with her?
But I only asked if you remember me.
Yes. We are very happy together. She is the light of my life.
I'm glad to hear that.
What are you getting at, Valencio?
Oh, nothing. Except maybe there is something in her history that you might not know about.
If it's the part about her spending a year at clown college after high school, I know all about that. She was young. She liked big shoes. They brainwashed her. If I ever get my hands on those clowns!
Oh no, this is something completely different.
I also happen to know how about her twin sister, Deborah, who you brainwashed in thinking she was my wife, while Nina was undergoing a secretive nose job in South America, and who later became pregnant but lost the baby. It was kidnapped by pirates and never be seen again.
I forgot about that time. That was fun. No, I have something even more disturbing to tell you. Your wife, Nina, is my daughter!
No!
Can someone turn the heat on in here and freeze my tuggies on?
How was that, Ollie?
Any good thing for us?
I've got a bit of a cold right now, but I'm not really.
I don't care, okay? Good.
Anybody got soup?
Someone's got soup, John.
I demand soup.
No, you can't demand anything.
I've been on this show for 47 years and I want soup. Cream of asparagus. Cream of asparagus or I go home right now.
Was I not gritting my teeth enough? Was that it? I've got a problem with one of my incisors, so I'm not able to cleanse my jaw like I used to.
Morris, 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 Morris.
What?
Shut up! That was wretched, okay? Wretched! Where was the intensity? Where was the drama?
There being drama, I had soup.
Hey, attention up here, Grandpa. You get soup after you nail the scene, alright?
It's in my contract that I get soup whenever I want.
Do you want me to have Valencio's personality downloaded into a computer again? So I can fire you and replace you with a CSA? Because I can do it. We're doing the scene again.
The whole thing?
Yes, the whole thing.
Oh, jeez.
This is ridiculous. I want double soup now.
There's no such thing as double. What is it, sweetheart?
It's not sweetheart, it's Caitlin.
Ask yourself one question. Do I care?
I just got the...
The answer is no.
I just got the ratings for last week.
Aw, oh, dang it. Not the plot line of the escaped mental patient with the poisonous fruit tree would really ruin the viewers.
I don't think people really understood the whole radioactive mango thing.
I'm not asking for your opinion, alright, babe? Why don't you do your job and set the props? We're doing the scene again.
Address the soup issue.
There is no soup issue!
There is most definitely a soup issue!
John! We'll deal with it after. Okay? before we do that, can we make some adjustments to my costume?
No! Laces, I think. Brooke, you ready?
No.
You're not ready?
I just stand here. What do you think?
Love the attitude, Brooke. From the top. In 5, 4, 3, 2.
Jake Strong! How nice of you to join me.
What do you want from me, Valencio Day? The patio?
Why are you so suspicious? Can't I invite my friend over for a nice little chat? Sherry!
The last time I touched your Sherry, I ended up in a mental hospital for 3 months. Then you convinced my half-brother to steal my family's fortune. So I think I'll decline the sherry, even though it looks pretty good, and I'm quite thirsty for riding my motorcycle.
Over here! As you wish, Jake Strong, as you wish. I would offer you soup, but I don't have any soup.
I must watch you!
Their screams were exquisite.
Goldfish don't scream!
yours did.
You monster!
Darling, I won't let you do this.
You just don't understand, do you, Mother? You're the monster, not Sebastian. I don't care that he wears an eye patch. I wouldn't care if he wore two eye patches and bumped around and stumbled into things. Because I love him. And I'll be the one looking out his passenger side rear view mirror to see objects that are closer than they appear to be. I raised you better than this. You didn't raise me. The nanny raised me.
How dare you?
This relationship is over.
You can't say that.
I just did.
You ungrateful child.
The next time I see you, you'll just be some nice lady in the kitchen who likes to do the dusting every once in a while and occasionally bake brownies. And I might take a brownie or two, but I'll pay you for them. We're leaving, and we're not even going to stay for dinner. We'll have Kentucky fried chicken.
Their chicken is substandard!
That's good enough for me. Come, fiancé.
Oh, one more thing. Would you like chicken or fish at the wedding?
Oh my gosh, you were amazing in that. Look at my skin. Goosebumps.
Yeah, whatever. Can I say something other than their chicken is substandard? That's a really stupid line.
You're a stupid line. And no, we cannot change the script.
How about their chicken is god-awful?
No, just,
ooh, causes cancer in rats.
Hey, kid, that was spectacular.
Really?
First rate work. You know what I like about you? Your hair.
I love my hair too.
What do you say you and I go backstage and rehearse?
Bill, could you refrain from hitting on the actresses for a moment?
Stuff it, Amy. You're just jealous.
Oh yeah. I'm jealous of a washed up, has been, mediocre slime bag.
What did you just call me?
Not you.
People, hey! See you from the cameras! Alright, it's 5 o'clock and Emmy's today is...
Molly, come on!
Who are you again?
Hi, I'm Carrie. I'm a new intern. This is my first day.
Hi!
I'm so excited to be here. I'm a huge fan of the show and this is such an amazing opportunity for me. I've dreamed about this my whole life!
You dreamed about being an intern on the soap opera? You need better dreams. Look, what's your name? Carly? Internships exist to give family members of the production staff something to do, all right? You're not going anywhere.
Oh, but I have something important to say.
Can you please spit it out? I'm about to die of boredom.
There's a lady who can talk to you in a suit. Martha?
Mary?
That's it. She's like the excellent producer or something.
Executive producer. Oh, dang it!
Everyone get out here!
I didn't think we were going back to that scene.
Caitlin, you don't have to yell. We all heard you.
Everyone get out here now!
I'm still having my suit.
John, get out here!
We'll throw your body in the river when I'm done with you.
Darlings, it's 5 o'clock and I'm beginning to turn into a pumpkin, so this better be quick. I also have to go home to feed President Bush and Laura Bush.
You have them trapped in your house?
Pomeranians. I also had one named Senator Arlen Specter.
What happened to him?
Her. She ran away. I don't like to speak about it. She was kidnapped, really. Held for ransom. It was a dark night. I had just received a phone call.
We did that one 12 years ago, Sybil.
I don't know what happened to my dog. I'm worried.
How am I not doing it, Wilson? 2 million. I don't care if that name is in the show. That's my week. Well, I don't care, Jimmy. I won't be doing soaps forever. Yeah, I know. Slumming it with the little people. Have you talked to Spielberg? We'll get him on the phone.
All right, everyone, listen up.
Do you mind? Jimmy, I want 2 cases of water in the trailer. Okay? Take 1 bottle. I want a new bottle instead. And aromatherapy cans. I know I don't have the part yet, but when I do...
Tyler!
Try not to be rude, okay? Nobody important. Like this. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? You just signed your death warrant, buddy. Death warrant!
Try it, poser. Have a seat. You're gonna love it here, Carrie.
You like to party?
Hey! Hey! Please!
Darlings, I have an announcement to make. I get a little loopy at night, just so you know.
You're a little loopy during the day, too.
That's how I met my first husband. It was a dark night, raining. I had just seen the ghost of...
You did that one 28 years ago.
Okay, thanks for that. But what I'm trying to say is I'm glad you're all here.
Hi, I'm Carrie.
Oh, hey, man. How nice of you to join us. Let's give Mary a round of applause.
Look, I don't have a lot of time, so I'll make this brief. I know you guys have been hearing a lot of rumors about the future of the show.
There are rumors?
Most of them are true. Look, we're just now reaching our audience, so the network is thinking about killing the show.
What? You can't do that!
It's about time.
Hey! Hey! No need to be upset, just because you probably won't have jobs anymore.
Look, I know we've had a bad run lately, but we can come back. We can do another story with cannibals. Everybody will love that. We'll get lost in South America or something.
Hey, you know what? You need a suit, girl. You think that hour slot's gonna fill itself every day? Ha!
This isn't 1954 anymore, Grandpa. I can place a show in 5 minutes with a cheaper soap opera made in China. They've got entire script factories turning out low-cost, high-quality television entertainment. You want to see efficiency on a set? They film 3 episodes a day. They pay their actors in birdseed and sell everyone 6 songs about how happy they are.
This is insane. You can't just
pay. Nothing's final yet. But unless you can show me some gain in productivity,
what are you talking about?
Here's the deal. You guys are the slowest shooting soap out there.
That's because we do quality.
No, it's because we argue about everything.
That's not true.
Yes, it is.
I'll shut you down.
You are proving my point. We can't afford to spend this much time on the show. You've got to speed it up. Here's the deal. Give me a high quality, top-notch episode by tomorrow morning. And maybe I'll recommend that we keep the show running.
We have to finish the show tonight?
Oh, come on, I get cranky at night. You're cranky all the time, and I have a right to be.
And Andy gets less attractive as the night goes on. Trust me, I've been there. High five.
Tough. Finish the show tonight, or you're doomed.
We can do it.
Yes. Right?
I'm with you. This is just too much for me emotionally. What will I do if I don't have this show? I could go back to modeling. I'll have to get my headshots, Rita.
I know a guy. Top notch. This is ridiculous. I'm going home.
Nobody's going home. I've had the intern.
And that's me.
Lock all the doors from the outside. We've sent all the other workers home. You're trapped here.
No, I've been quiet because I'm trying to be a pleasant person. It's a new thing my quarter of therapists have suggested. But let me say a little something here.
Here we go.
Morris, remember the time when I apologized for biting you in the arm and sending you to the hospital?
I think I have post-traumatic stress disorder for the apology.
Yeah, well, most of me has now denounced violence. But there's still part of me that could be convinced, okay?
Shut your mouth.
I like her. All right, Miss Director Lady.
Producer.
Whatever. You think we come to work every day and don't act our hearts out? Is that it? Look at John. As far as I'm concerned, that man is acting personified. If you took the idea of acting and made it into a 6-year-old man with gout, an occasional hernia, and a strange need for soup, that would be it. And look at Amy over there. She's maybe 50 years old already and she...
I'm 39!
And she's getting old and disgusting. Not nearly as attractive as she used to be. But she's still here acting her guts out. And the rest of the people on the cast might not have enough talent to make it in Hollywood, but they have just enough talent for daytime TV. And that's good enough for the doctor's offices and laundromats and homeschooled kids. I say we have a good show. I said we had a great show. And if anyone has a problem with that, I will kick you in the head until you think about it differently. Right, everyone?
I'm not quite sure what your point is. I like your tone, though.
Here it is. I am not that stable. You do not want me in the rest of society. There's only one career where a person with as many personality disorders as me could possibly make a living, and that's acting. So if you take this away from me, I promise you, I will be the bad lady screaming outside your house at 3 in the morning. Okay? I know where you live.
And I know where you live. I know where everyone lives.
Freedom of Information Act? You can find this stuff out.
Look, I'm on your side. I don't want a Chinese soap opera. They sing in that really weird way.
That's Chinese opera. My Pomeranians love Chinese opera. Really gets them howling.
Either way, but you guys gotta show it to me. Otherwise, you're all fired. Except Danielle. I think I've got a spot for you on the Chinese show. If you can learn the language.
I can totally do that. I have no standards at all.
Perfect.
That's what I like to hear. Sayonara.
That's Japanese.
Okay, goodbye then. In Chinese.
Wait, what just happened?
Oh, wake up, Tyler!
I'm awake, thank you very much. I just have a lot more important things to think about, like myself and how awesome I am. Nice.
We're all gonna get fired if we can't finish the shoot tonight.
Hey, thanks. Now I know.
Alright, everyone, gather around. I know I'm not one for emotional speeches, but you know where I got my start?
No, and I don't care either.
I was 8 years old. My parents bought me a video camera for Christmas. It ran on my imagination. But later I got a real one. I staged movies in my room. Little shows I put on. Put my teddy bear in a dress.
You're sick.
All my stuff locked in a tuxedo. Stage a wedding between them. And then have a pants show and start throwing punches everywhere. Sometimes I use my father's razor. He used big disposables. And shave little parts out of them to say if they were injured during the fight. And then there'd be a frog doctor who fell in love. And then there'd be another frog doctor who looked exactly the same and was also in love.
Does this story have a point?
Shh. What happened to the frog doctor? My point is this. I am soap opera. When I'm in the shower in the morning, I'm thinking about soap opera. When I'm eating breakfast, I'm thinking about soap opera. When I'm asleep, I'm having very disturbing dreams about soap opera. I don't have a wife. I don't have friends. I don't have anyone who loves me. I'm really kind of sad and alone in this world, but I have this. Who's with me?
I am.
Okay, good.
Can I change some of my lines?
No, you cannot change any of your lines!
I would not say the words of standard!
Can I just say something here? I've had a great time working with you people, but really I'm just poised to be a lot more famous than all of you, so...
You're staying here!
You just signed your death warrant! It's a line from the film I'm auditioning for. Death warrant, Matt Damon. And I'm insecure about my body image!
Shut up! Shut up, all of you! We're doing this! We're doing the show! And no one's leaving until we've either finished or we're all dead! Okay? Places for scene 3.
Places for scene 3.
I'll get you
for this. I'll put a sock in it!
I will, and then I'll get you.
Hey there, boss man.
I don't have time, Bill.
I know, right? Who's got time anymore? Anywho, I've got a date tonight. Smoking hot.
No.
In fact, I have 3 dates.
No, you're staying here.
Can I invite them to set?
No, go to your dressing room.
Man, you used to be cool. Now you disgust me. I'll remember this.
Places in the hospital.
And 5, 4, 3, 2,
no. No, please. You can't do this to them. Oh, it was just a dream.
I see you're feeling better, Mom.
Doctor, I have the dream again.
It's just a result of the sedative I gave you.
No, it's not. They're in trouble. I know they are.
You need to get a hold of yourself, Mona. world out there that needs you. It needs your spirit, your energy. You can't let yourself be dragged down into the malaise of this swamp. I tell you to give and live. Live like you've never lived before. And then, all the people that ever doubted you, you're gonna sign their death warrant.
Cut!
What?
Stop it, Watts! This isn't an audition for your movie!
Did we get that tape, though? Can I have that for my reel?
No! You can't end up your reel!
I already deleted it.
Are you kidding me?
Take it back and do it again. And 5, 4, 3, 2...
You need to get a hold of yourself, woman.
I'm trying, Doctor, but the dream seems so real. I have to warn my grandchildren.
You need to sleep. You need to sleep for a long, long time.
William!
Sequoia! I thought I told you never to meet me here!
I just needed to see you. They're saying such terrible things about you.
No.
Yes!
No.
It's not true, is it?
Of course it's not true.
You didn't give someone a hamster kidney instead of a real kidney in a bizarre transplant scam?
Where would I even get a hamster kidney? I'm not even sure if hamsters have kidneys.
You didn't steal a hamster from a kindergarten class and use it in experiments? And then sold the real kidneys on the black market to Serbian gangsters who in turn financed an independent film about Dungeons and Dragons?
Darling, it's me, it's Dr. William. I would never harm a hamster. And I don't like independent film or servants.
Oh, I was so worried.
Don't. Remember, there's a great big world out there that needs you. It needs your spirit, your energy. You can't let yourself be jacked down into the malaise of this swamp. I tell you to give and live. Live like you've never lived before. And then...
Cut!
Dang it! You crossed me for the last time!
Go back! And 5, 4, 3, 2...
Oh, I was so worried.
Don't be. Here, take some of these pills.
What do these do?
Don't question me! I'm sorry. They'll call me for a time. Take them now.
I already feel better, and I'm no longer concerned about your possible organ harvesting.
Excellent. Why don't you lie down over here? Well, you look so lovely today.
Thank you. Can I just sleep here?
Sure. You can sleep for a long, long time. Oh, nurse, I believe we have another candidate for a kidney transplant.
I don't buy the laugh.
Are you kidding me?
That laugh was pathetic. It should be like, mwahahaha!
Or more like,
my uncle laughed like that. He had an evil streak too. He owned a bear and trained it to attack my sister-in-law because... Well, at least I think he did. But his laugh, I remember it. No, that wasn't it. It's more like...
And how about this?
Are you okay?
No! Go away! We'll need to water the plant. I don't care if you're busy. We've got orphans. They're very demanding. That's weird. The power's gone. It's an old building, I guess. Hello? Hello? I gotta call you back. Hello?
Locked from the outside. I can only conclude that
this is the set of a soap opera.
Wait a second. Why are you in such a rush to get back to filming?
And so quick to take over.
Maybe you killed him. Just like a woman. Murderer.
What? That's ridiculous. I would never...
May I remind some of you that you threatened to kill him several minutes ago? John!
So I had good reason. Just so you all know, I don't get soup, somebody dies. Not that I didn't.
And... Tyler!
It was a line from a movie, you moron. You think you're so smart that you just signed your death warrant.
Are you still rehearsing?
No. That was a threat against you. Watch yourself.
And I heard Bill threaten him later.
Oh, come off it. If anyone's a killer here, it's Danielle.
Me? Yeah, that's right. It was Danielle. She's a killer. I'm the nicest person here.
But how do we know it's not all an act? That's what you do for a living, right?
You're an actor. We're all actors.
You people are actors. I'm a stud.
Where were you when he was killed?
In my dressing room, playing dress up.
But you look behind you. Who's that face in the mirror? A man. A strange man.
No, I was alone. You can't think I would do it. I don't even have a motive.
Here's a motive for you. You're a washed-up has-been at age 23, and you've been in and out of acting camps every summer since you were 12. Secretly, you're aware that you're not very talented and not as attractive as you think you are. You've got one chance left to prove yourself, to give the best acting performance of your life. So what do? You kill the director and act like you didn't kill it. You can sell that, you can sell anything. Well, sweetheart, the Oscar for being a lying murderer is called prison, and that's where you're headed.
You're saying I killed him for acting practice? And to think I trusted you.
I didn't do it.
Bravo, Danielle. Bravo.
Danielle didn't kill him.
How did you know?
I was listening to her door the whole time.
I thought you were making out with me the whole time.
I was making out with you and listening to her door at the same time.
What?
That's so romantic. Why do I keep falling for you?
Because I'm a matador of love.
And you're the bull. Charge for a tag. Whoops. It's gone. And I dance around you and wear tight pants at the same time.
We are so
over!
So be it. That just means Bill is on the prowl, ladies. Your door says no. Your heart says probably not. But your feet say maybe.
People, can we focus for a second here? I know we're all concerned about who murdered Ollie, but this episode has to be in by 8 a.m. tomorrow or heads are gonna roll. More heads. Not in a literal sense.
Let's hope.
Look. I can't go out there and act in a soap opera after the director has been killed. I can't do it. I'll do your work. All right, fine. I'll do it.
But really, if you need me to do anything, I'll do it. I'll even be the director. That's okay. I've got the director's hat now, and that makes me the director. And that means that I'm angry with all of you. Places for scene four.
Can I point out that we even come close? You're discovering the killer!
Places for scene four! Oh, can I be the stage manager now? Knock yourself out. It's a thankless job, and nobody likes you.
True. There is a dead body here.
Stage manager's job. Darn it. Can I get some help? Sweetheart, they're the talent. You're the stage manager. That means that you're gonna have to drag off the body, find a place to store it, and probably make arrangements to have it removed. And by the way, you're not gonna be. This is worse than being an intern, yeah?
Guys!
I'm not helping. I just got a manicure.
sociopaths.
That's why my therapist said I'd be perfect for soap opera.
We need Eileen and Jake.
Eileen and Jake.
Everyone else, off.
So no one would try to kill me when I'm off stage. Caitlin, I don't really think I can do this.
I guess soap opera digest was right. You really have lost your mojo, haven't you?
All right, fine. But after we do this scene, we work on who killed Ollie.
I'm not making any promises. Places!
Places!
And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
You don't say one.
It comes after two.
I went to kindergarten too. You don't say one. Stop it, Kim. And make a silent one.
Why?
Just shut up and do it before I strangle you!
Brooke?
I can't hear you.
Thank you so much for giving me another chance.
Between you and me, you're way better than Ollie ever was.
I think it's really, really great that strong women are getting ahead in this business. Like, my whole career, I want to model it right after you.
Are you a size 6? Because I can totally wear these clothes.
Oh, sorry. And 5, 4, 3, 2.
Jake Strong?
Thought I'd find you here.
It's my house!
That's why I thought I'd find you here. How are you, Eileen?
You can't just walk back into my life like this.
I am, and I'm doing it.
Walking.
You always liked the way I walked.
Didn't you?
Please leave. It's too painful to see you. Too painful!
Is that any more painful than being massaged with porcupines? Because that's the way I feel when I look at you. Look at me!
No!
Look at me!
No!
Look at me!
Ah!
You're still beautiful, Eileen.
Please, Jake Strong, you're married. I was at your wedding. In secret.
I know, but there's something you never told me.
I told you my whole heart!
I spoke of Blanchard and the bomb!
No.
Yes, you want to know what he told me about my darling wife? My wife that I love constantly for 1.5 years after rescuing her from gypsies!
I know.
And you couldn't tell me!
How could I tell you? You wouldn't listen!
She is the daughter of my arch enemy! Every time I look at her, I see his evil face!
Just turn her around then!
No! It's just so terrible!
She might be his daughter. But she might not be evil. You could give her a chance.
No! It's over. My marriage is over.
What does that mean for us?
Eileen.
Jake Strong.
No! I can't do it! I can't do this!
I can't live knowing you're with another woman!
You must!
I can't!
You must! Oh, I shouldn't have come here! It's just too painful to see you! Ah! My brother, he's a genetic experiment gone wrong.
My daughter is going to marry him.
No, I'll kill him.
Don't try, Jake. He's been trained by Navy SEALs, and he also went to ninja school. You don't stand a chance.
He must be stopped.
I know, but how?
Cut. What are you waiting for?
There's supposed to be a doorbell there. Sequoia comes in.
Sequoia, you ready? Where's Carrie?
Bobbing Bill.
Bill, I will murder you with my bare hands!
Maybe that's something we shouldn't be saying.
Bill, leave Carrie alone. You are a sad, pathetic man, and I never loved you. But if you change your mind, I'm still available.
You know, Amy, I'm single.
That must be really nice.
All right, let's take it back. Places, and 5, 4, 3, 2.
He must be stopped.
I know, but how?
I hear the doorbell.
I didn't hear anything.
I have amazing ears.
Cut! Lily, this is not the time to fake fading spells for one of your partners.
She was killed! Look! This is a knife!
It was Morris!
I was standing in front of you when it happened.
It could have been a slow-acting knife.
What the heck is a slow-acting knife? There's a murderer loose backstage! Round everyone up!
Morris, I hate to interrupt your little witch hunt, but I'm still the director here. And that means that I decide when we round everyone up so you can freak out and interrogate them all.
There are two people dead now!
Think about how many people die on this planet every day, and you'll understand what a ridiculous statement that was. Get a little perspective, please.
No, that was in 72. I remember because I had gout, and you thought I said goat, and for some reason you love goats.
I didn't know about goats, you senile codger.
You're a goat! People, please! Where's Tyler? We have a crisis!
No,
so?
Why isn't anyone doing something about the seltzer?
Oh, that was fun!
Are we missing anyone?
Hi.
Where were you?
I got lost. It's so amazing back there.
All right, we've had another murder!
Oh, come on. Didn't we just do murder? Do we have to use the same plots over and over again?
Someone killed Lily!
Oh, put on some pants, Bill.
I'd like that, wouldn't you?
You are disgusting and sad and pathetic.
Yet, you are drawn to me like a parking cop to a flashing parking meter.
Yes.
Hey!
Sorry, I can't help myself.
Bill! Cool it!
Or someone's gonna kill you.
No! Stop making threats! There are people being killed!
She didn't even have a major part of me.
Doesn't matter. There is a murderer amongst us!
Using a word like amongst.
This is like a murder of cats.
Everyone, sit down.
I want a cushy chair.
Just sit down! The doors are locked from the outside. Someone has cut our cell phone service. Get a grip, Tyler! Ollie has been bludgeoned to death, and now Lily has been stabbed. The murderer is sitting right here.
This is exciting. Also, we have to finish filming the rest of the episode.
No, we don't! We can stop filming because that's what any sane, decent human beings would do.
Which is precisely why we continue to film. The murderer would expect us to stop, so we won't.
Have you been replaced by a robot or something? You used to be nice.
That was before I assumed power. Now I've been corrupted. That sounds great. You wouldn't believe. I'm up for anything, really. I can talk about the murders or film another scene. That's a great attitude, Danielle.
No, it's not! No, it's not!
Morris, if we allow the killers to change who we are and prevent us from filming this show, then they've already won.
No, actually, if they kill people and get away with it, then they win.
Excuse me. I think I know a thing or two about murder. And it's this. If the murderer wants to be caught, you'll catch him. But if he doesn't want to be caught, then you won't catch him. Especially if he's careful and uses a technique no one's allowed. Well, I wouldn't know anything about that.
I agree with John. No use going after the killer.
True. Yeah. All right, that's settled. Now, we have to finish filming the scene, but Lily's dead.
I'll clear her. I already had her costume altered to fit me, and I would have gone for the backstage.
You are so enthusiastic. So are you. Great. Okay. Places for Sequoia's entrance. Nice work, Carrie.
Hey! Don't you find it slightly suspicious that she already has the part memorized?
No, I don't. And I don't like those insinuations.
Places!
Don't look at me. I'm just the camera woman, and
is not!
I know, but how?
You know.
It's the doorbell!
Sequoia?
You're probably wondering why I look different. It was Dr. William.
I don't trust him.
I know, but I completely changed my appearance for him because I thought he would like me better this way.
What are you doing here?
I have to tell you something. Something I've never told anyone. A secret.
Maybe I should go.
No, stay. It concerns you too. Please, I feel just awful. Sometimes when I'm alone, staring at the moon, I wonder what it would be like to be weightless, to float above the earth and see all the problems here on this planet, like an alien would, in some strange, incomprehensible language. Maybe that alien wouldn't even have ears. They just have sort of holes in the side of their head that they would also breathe through. But I would swirl, oh how I would swirl out there in space. A spinning star of my own, giving out light and life to my own universe. And then, here on this planet, I can see the...
That's nice, boy!
No! Don't you see, J. Strong? Don't you see the crops here on this planet? The dazzling, mad, insane little place we call Earth. Sometimes, I wish I was an octopus, so I could have 8 arms and be able to do lots of things at the same time. And also have suckers, because... those would be cool too. Although I imagine I'd get stuck against a wall.
Maybe you could tell us what's bothering you.
Oh, okay. Remember how when your baby was 6 months old, I was your babysitter?
Yes.
Well, when no one was looking, I switched the baby with another baby I had in the back of my car and no one noticed.
What?
No!
Doesn't help me.
And 5, 4, 3,
crazy.
We've got new leadership, okay? Crazy is how I do things. Let's go. Brooke, is there any way we can get some sound effects? Nice. That was a bee. Save it for the cameras, Danielle!
It was.
It was what? Finish your sentence.
It was.